happy Vlogmas. I don't know what day this palette video is going up, but I am trying to pre-film so I can be prepared to provide content for you every day in the month of December. So if you're proud of me, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you can follow along on my magical Vlogmas adventures. So today I thought it would be fun for me to show you guys my rainbow eyeshadow palette collection, because God knows I've got a lot of eyeshadow palettes, and I thought it would be kind of fun to break up an eyeshadow palette collection and kind of show you guys like bits and pieces here and there, because sometimes people just love looking at eyeshadows. And I have a full collection on my channel, which is about half a year old. So that is my like most watched video on my channel. If you guys want to check that out, you'll definitely be able to find it quite quickly. But I just thought it'd be fun to do like a rainbow collection, and then I think sometime in 2020 I'll film a full eyeshadow palette collection again, kind of showing you guys what I've kept, what I've decluttered. It'll give you guys a really good idea, but I am in the process of also decluttering my collection, so this is kind of a fun way for me to look at the different things in my collection and narrow it down. So if you're excited to see all of my rainbow eyeshadow palettes, just keep watching. So the first palette I want to talk to you guys about is this. This is new to my collection. This is the Warrior 3 palette by Juvia's Place. As you can see, I have not used this yet, but it's definitely very, very exciting to me. Angelica definitely sold me this palette. I wasn't gonna buy it, and then she did a 3 looks, 1 palette, and I was like, give me that sucker. So I bought it, and I'm definitely planning on playing with it, and I just think it's beautiful, and it looks like it's gonna be really amazing quality. So I'm so happy I have that. Another Juvia's Place is the Zulu by Juvia's. I am not gonna lie, I haven't used this palette in a hot second, but it has some beautiful shades and as well as some neutrals. But you guys know Juvia's is known for their color, so I thought I'd include that. I also have a few other palettes from them, but I just thought the Zulu and the Warrior 2 were like the most like rainbowy ones that I have. Kind of declutter them too, because there were a lot of palettes I felt like I was holding on to but I wasn't really using. So I don't have every single Juvia's Place palette anymore. I used to, but I decided that that was a very unhealthy habit to have. And then they also did a few neutral palettes, and I'm like, eh, I already have those in my collection. So I've been managing my Juvia's Place obsession quite well, if I do say so myself. Okay, this palette I meant to film a video with and I never did, but I actually did use it a few times off camera. This is the It's My Rare second collab that they did, and this was so fun because it pairs so well with the original palette. I think this was really well thought out. Like, the fact that they did some neutrals and then some more pops of color so you could really combine the two palettes together. Very genius idea from her. I don't see a lot of brands doing that, so I thought that was a really, really smart move, and I think this is a cute palette. The quality is really good as well, and it is affordable because it is from BH Cosmetics, and everything about it is super cute, so I really like this palette. Another collab palette that is kind of a grungy rainbow, as Hannah Louise Poston would like to call it. This is the collab between Makeup Shayla and ColourPop, the Perception palette, right? Yep, that's what it's called. Here it is. It's very much a rainbow palette, but it's very muted. I think I could almost fit this in the neutral with a pop of color category too, but I decided to throw it in my rainbow palette collection. Let me know what you guys think. Is this more of a neutral palette with a pop of color, or is it considered a rainbow palette? I don't know. What do you guys think? But I just thought I'd throw it in here. Definitely need to use this one more. I just wanted to show it to you guys. Another palette from ColourPop. I really think I need to declutter this one. This is also another more grungy palette. This is from the Misunderstood, or the Villains collection. This is the Misunderstood palette, and I bought the first one, so then I felt peer pressure to buy the second one, and now they've got a third one, and I was like, no, I'm drawing the line in the sand. I'm not buying any more of these Disney collabs, because they're nice, because they're ColourPop, but I don't know, I don't really gravitate towards Disney stuff, so yeah, I think I'm gonna declutter this actually. Okay, this palette is so cute. This is their holiday from last year. This is Chasing Rainbows. So there's no green in here, but there's blues, there's pinks, there's purples, yellow, gold shade. So I feel like this is justified in being called a rainbow palette, plus the name is Chasing Rainbows, so I mean, come on. This is beautiful. My friend, her channel is called Beauty Gurus Wannabe, I think. She uses so many of these shadows in her makeup looks, and she's makes this palette look so beautiful, and like, she's literally got me thinking about this palette and how I need to pull it out and use it, so I definitely will be doing that in the future. Okay, this palette, I was gonna do some things with it. I had plans for this palette, guys. I was so excited when I saw that Profusion had a $5 rainbow palette. I was like, yes, queen. And then I didn't do anything with it. I was gonna maybe even consider. Okay, this is my Viseart palette, by the way. I forgot. This is their Editorial Brights. I need to glue the pans in, but they're fine and they're like all loose and stuff. But I thought this would be such a great dupe for this one. And this is $80 and this is $5. So I did want to do a comparison at some point, but of course I definitely didn't end up doing that. So I think I'm going to declutter this, but yeah, I don't know. I don't really love the Profusion stuff that I've tried. I know people say it's really good, but I just have so many palettes, you guys. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and declutter this. Okay, so then let's really quick talk about the Viseart palette. Yeah, I need to glue these in here, but I just leave them like, I don't know, chilling. I really like the Viseart mattes. Is this a must-have palette? I don't think so. I think you can find these shades for a much affordable price point in other brands and stuff like that. Of course, you'll see I have a ton of rainbow palettes, but yeah, I'm glad I have this, but it's definitely not an essential. So definitely save your money and buy something else if you've been eyeing that palette for a long time. Okay, this is a random one. This is in my try and buy series. I bought this and then I never put it on my eyes, but I thought it would be fun to include it in my rainbow palette collection because it has the green, the pink, the orange, the blue. So it's got the whole rainbow pretty much in here. This is definitely a bulky palette. I still haven't put this on my eyes yet, but you guys know I will be testing it out for my try and buy series. So you guys can keep your eye out for a video on this palette, hopefully soon. Hopefully soon. The next rainbow palettes are also BH Cosmetics. Apparently I love BH Cosmetics. I am on a BH Cosmetics no buy, guys, because I bought so many of their palettes and never used them. So this was a really cute one. This is called the Illusion 16 color shadow palette from BH, and as you can see, there's some oranges, some purples, some greens, some blues, as well as some neutrals, which is so fun. This palette was super affordable, which is probably why I picked it up, but I haven't ever used it, so I think I'm gonna actually put this in a giveaway for you guys to try out, because if I haven't used it by now, I'm never gonna use it, and I'd much rather go to a good home. The next palette I bought from BH and also never used is their Daisy Marquez collab. Again, I'm so sad that I didn't ever use this, but that's okay. Again, I'm gonna probably be decluttering this because I just don't have time to go back and talk about palettes that nobody cares about anymore, to be very honest. And even though I spent the money, I don't need to keep it for the sake of keeping it. So this one is also gonna go away, but new rule, I swear, it's like, don't buy palettes if you didn't buy them on launch day. Don't go back and think about them and think about them. I heard Annette mention that. I'm like, God, that's such a good rule. Like, if I don't want it the first time, I'm not gonna want it the second or third time, or if it's on sale. So that's like my new mantra for myself. Okay, so this palette I'm gonna keep. I actually really like this BH palette. This is their Weekend Festival palette. You can't buy this anymore, but it's so pretty. It's one of the first BH palettes I bought in a long, long time that really made me fall in love with the brand. So I'm happy to have this, and it is gonna, you know, hang out in my collection for maybe another year. We'll see how that goes. And then I, of course, had to pick up part two. This is the Color Festival palette, and this came out this year for festival season. They also had a brush set that launched with this, but this is really cute, and I think I might, maybe we'll see, I may film a video with this. If I don't get to it by the end of 2020, I think this one will be going bye-bye as well. This is one of my all-time regrets, is the Sugar Pill palette. This is the 12-pan palette where you can do like a build your own palette. Now, there is a lot of hype for Sugar Pill mattes, and a lot of people say the reasoning is because there wasn't a lot of color when YouTube like first started and beauty YouTube, so a lot of beauty YouTubers clung to their Sugar Pill palettes. I don't get the hype with this at all, and this was like one of my most expensive like palette purchases. It's like $125 or something dollars, and I really don't like this palette, so I will be decluttering this. I'll probably put it on Poshmark because I spent my own money on it, and I would love to try and recoup some of the damage I did. So if you guys are interested in trying Sugar Pill, just know that sometime in the future this will be in my Poshmark for you guys to buy, because I just don't like it. And I know some people love it. So if it can go to a good home, I'd be really happy about that. Next palette. This one was a birthday gift from one of my close friends. This is the James Charles X Morphe palette. I've mentioned this in a few other videos and I've literally only used like one or two of the shades. So my goal for 2020 is definitely to try this out and maybe even review it. I don't know. Maybe you guys would still be interested in hearing my thoughts on it. I mean, I know it's kind of old news, but I feel like, you know, every time James Charles gets into a controversy, another 8 billion palettes of his sell. So I'm sure there's people out there still rooting for the guy, and I'd be more than happy to provide you with an unbiased review. This is kind of a regret of 2020. You guys haven't seen this palette on my channel yet. I did play with it a little bit, and I didn't really love the formula. I was like, okay, I need to stop buying ColourPop palettes. Like, it's not the greatest. I don't know. I was so, like, sucked in by the promo pictures because it made it look so colorful and fun. And, I mean, look at this packaging. She, like, knocked it out of the park. You know what I mean? I'm still going to try this and film something for my channel because I feel like this is still relevant. And a lot of people still love Kathleen Lights and will be searching for reviews on this. So let me know if you guys would like to see it, but I think I'm going to do it anyway. Like, I'd be interested to hear if you guys would like to see that. Here's another Morphe palette that your girl bought and never did anything with it. This was totally peer pressure. Not peer pressure. She didn't peer pressure me, but FOMO set in because Spooky Lips and Fat Hips, Lacey, loves this palette and loved to talk about this palette. And then when they relaunched it, I was like, give me that palette. And so I bought it. But it's definitely one of those that I need to like test and like decide if I want to keep it or not, because the whole time I've had it, I've never reached for it. And I feel like that's a pretty good sign that I'm probably never going to reach for it, but I'm going to see, I'm going to hang on to it in 2020 and try and make up my mind before the end of 2020 so we can make some progress and move on with our lives. Here is another palette. Oh my gosh, these colors just sucked me in. Plus, everyone gave the first palette such good reviews. So this is the Be Perfect and Stacey Marie collab. This is their XL Pro something. It's like giant and colorful, and I've seen so many makeup artists do such beautiful looks with this that I thought that I could also do beautiful looks with it. So I did pick it up. I've used it like once and I wasn't very impressed with the formula, but I plan on trying it out again and hopefully it'll do a good job, because otherwise I'll be really sad that I spent the money on it. A really good rainbow palette that is affordable is this guy. This is by Certify and it's the Tropical Wonders palette. I think this is the first rainbow palette that I ever picked up from them. And I actually really like this. I think it's a good palette. I would recommend you guys picking it up, especially if you can get it on sale. It's definitely a favorite of mine. I don't know if this qualifies as a rainbow palette, but I thought it did because, again, it has greens, purples, blues, and some pinks, and, you know, some duochromes. It's a pretty bomb palette. This is the BH Cosmetics Zodiac palette. One of my first loves with BH Cosmetics, and their bake formula is so good. I love to use it with a glitter glue is how I like to use it, and these mattes are amazing. This, like, pukey tone green was amazing. I love this palette so much, so I'm definitely going to be holding on to that. And this is kind of a crazy palette purchase. I think I should try and declutter this, but it's so fun. It's such a good formula. This green shade, like, come on. That's like my favorite shade of green. It's like a pure green. And this is a Glam Light. What is this even called? The Paint Palette. And this came out this year, and I don't know, you guys. I think Glam Light has Afterpay, and apparently I thought it was a good idea to get it with Afterpay. The Jawbreaker palette, this is like the most psychedelic rainbow palette of 2019. I think I filmed like one look with this palette and I've maybe used it twice. Like, I need to stop, y'all. Like, now that I have like these bookshelves and stuff and I can like display my palettes, I'm really realizing that I genuinely have a problem and I have too many eyeshadows. So my goal for 2020 is to really try out my palettes and narrow it down. Now, does this qualify as a rainbow palette because it has that neon section? I feel like I thought it did, but now that I look at it, I feel kind of silly. This is the newest member of my Morphe palette collection. I actually really like this palette. This is a 39L Hit the Lights palette, and it's super fun. It has those neons, it has some neutrals, it has some cool tones, and then it has like this awesome red section. So you can do a lot with this. Plus, it has these giant highlighter shades. So I think this is like a really fun one for a makeup beginner or somebody that you want to get a gift for, because the shades work really well. They blend very easily. And I love that you can also get highlighters in this palette. So it's kind of like a twofer, and it's like a little bit more expensive for Morphe. So it's nice that it has like a few different uses. And if you have like sisters, you know, you can like share, which I think is cool. Instead of like buying like 100 different palettes, you can kind of get different looks from one giant palette. So that's always handy. So that's everything for my Rainbow Palette Collection, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for sticking with me through Vlogmas. I appreciate you guys so, so much. I hope you are having a wonderful holiday season, and I will see you in my next video soon. Bye, guys.